Hello everyone, welcome back to a new session on dentistry and more. Let's continue our periodontic sessions. So last session I was talking about first transitional period and the changes happening in the oral cavity during this particular period, that was exchange of primary incisors by permanent incisors and the eruption of permanent first molars. So while the eruption of permanent first molars is concerned, there is a lot of occlusal changes is happening that we had seen from flush terminal plane to mesial step to distal step. So in this video I'll be explaining about what happens exactly when the permanent molars are erupting and how it is getting fixed to its final position utilizing certain spaces. So one of my video was explaining about primate space and leeway space, so hope you had watched that video, so that might help to understand this video completely, because the concept is all about primate space and leeway space. So to brush up the idea, primate space is nothing but simian space. It's also called as simian space. It is space present between canines, anterior to canine, in maxillary arch, not this one, anterior to canine and posterior to canine, anterior to canine in maxillary arch and posterior to canine in mandibular arch, that is between canine to central lateral incisor in maxillary arch and canine to first deciduous molar in lower arch. This space is known as primate space. So most of the cases when first molars are erupting, it utilizes the primate space and finally getting to class 1 molar relation, that is its final position. How it is happening is eruptive forces of first permanent molar pushes the deciduous molars to utilize the space and provide space for these maxillary and mandibular teeth, that is first permanent molar. So these forces pushes the deciduous molars to utilize the primate space present in the upper and lower arch and give space for the permanent first molar. So that is the early mesial shift. It happens during early mixed dentition. Okay, so this happens during 6 to 7 years, because most of the time the first molars erupts during that period. So it utilizes primate space, closes the primate space and arriving to class 1 molar relationship. That is early mesial shift concept. So what is late mesial shift concept? That is happening during the late mixed dentition period. So late mesial shift is happening during the late mixed dentition period. When primate space is absent, this concept will be working, because there is no space for this primary, no space provided by this primary dentition for the first permanent molars. So that time it utilizes the leeway space. Leeway space is nothing but the difference between primary canine and molars and its successors, that is permanent canine and premolars. So that is the difference. So that difference is known as leeway space. It is the combined mesiodistal width of primary canine and molars with against the permanent canine and premolars. So that space will be utilized. But what happens is it is utilized only after the exfoliation of primary molars. So primary molars usually exfoliated during 10 to 12 years. So this happens at late mixed dentition period, 10 to 12 years. So once these teeth are exfoliated, the permanent first molars drift mesially, so you can see the arrow marks, it drift mesially and utilizes the leeway space and reaches up to class 1 molar relation. So here it is different concept. It utilizes a primate space, but here it is utilizing the leeway space. So primate space and leeway space is happening early mesial shift and late mesial shift. This is during early mixer transition, maybe 6 to 7 years. This is 10 to 12 years. The basic difference is utilizing the primate space and utilizing the leeway space. So that's all about the mesial shift, early mesial shift and late mesial shift, and how the permanent molars are getting its ultimate position in the adult oral cavity. Okay, I'll come up with a new video. Thank you.